Assalamualaikum. Welcome to your online class from Dhaka Secondary School. This video is for class 5 English Literature and your chapter is The First Spider, page number 12 to 17. So Arachne receives a visitor. I'm going to read this. There was a knock at the door of Arachne's house. Come in, she called. She was quite used to visitors. Already a circle of interested people stood around her. They had come to watch Arachne doing her work. Sit down, said Arachne to the old woman. I am spinning wool to make thread at the moment. She had some sheep's wool at her feet. Her busy fingers were spinning the wool into beautiful strong thread. Her hands moved so fast that Minerva could hardly see them. When I finish spinning this wool, said Arachne after a few moments, I shall start weaving a new piece of cloth to make a picture. Watch carefully, you do not often see a real artist at work. They say the goddess Minerva herself is jealous of my skill. She started her new picture. Trees and hills appeared like magic before the eyes of the pupil. As she worked, Arachne talked to everyone about how clever she was and how no one could make pictures as well as she could. Minerva grew more and more angry. A proud and foolish girl, Minerva stepped forward and laid a gentle hand on the girl's arm. Dear child, she said, it is dangerous to boast too loudly about your skill. The gods may hear. I want them to hear, cried the proud and foolish girl. Jealous, I want them to see for themselves. They are afraid if they could not better than they are. Listen to an old woman. Dear, I have lived a long time and I have met many clever, proud young people. Their life did not always end happily. You spin and weave wonderfully well, but you are only human. Do not compare yourself with the gods. Ask Minerva's pardon for your foolish boasting. I promise you that she will forgive you. Why should Minerva forgive me? Cried Arachne. I only spoke the truth. You do not understand. You are just a poor old woman, and your mind is as weak as your poor, tired old body. I tell you, Minerva should come here and try her skill. I will show everyone that I spoke the truth. I think she must be afraid of the test. Why hasn't she come before? Then Minerva dropped her stick and stood up very straight. She tore the black cloth off her hair and she said a magic word. Arachne and the people around her saw the tall goddess standing there. She looked very strong and very beautiful. The other people at once fell on their knees and prayed to Minerva. Arachne was the only one who did not move. She held her head up high and showed no sign of fear. Only one who did not move. So you have come after all, she said. Let us start the test at once and see which of us is better at spinning and weaving and making beautiful pictures. The test. Without another word, the goddess and the girl began to work. The people in the room watched. No one spoke. They were almost afraid to breathe. In the center of Minerva's piece of cloth, a picture began to appear. It was a picture about foolish humans who would not obey the gods. It showed what bad things happened to these people. The goddess hoped that Arachne would look at the picture and learn a lesson. But Arachne was not frightened at all. Arachne worked and worked. Her cheeks were pink and she breathed quite fast. Her fingers flew backwards and forwards over the cloth. Soon a picture began to appear. It was so beautiful that it filled the pupil with joy. You could see hills covered with trees, a bright blue sky with white clouds, and the beautiful dark blue sea. You could almost hear the waves on the seashore. You could almost feel the wind in the trees. You could almost reach out and touch the floor. But when the pupil saw the subject of Arachne's picture, they were afraid. Arachne was telling a story too. Her story showed that even the gods can sometimes make mistakes. Minerva is angry At last, both pictures were finished. Now the gods never told lies, and Minerva had to tell the truth about Arachne's work. She had to admit that the girl had won. Arachne's skill was greater than her works, her own. "You win," Minerva said. She was angry. She did not like to say that Arachne was better than she was, and she wanted to punish Arachne for that. Arachne saw the angry look on the goddess' face. Suddenly, she understood how foolish she had been. She also knew that she was in terrible danger. She wanted to beg Minerva's pardon. "Forgive me," she said, but it was too late. With a scream of anger and hate, Minerva picked up Arachne's beautiful cloth. She tore it into small pieces. She threw the pieces at the pupil. Then she picked up her stick and hit Arachne 3 times on the head. Arachne was too proud. She could not leave after this terrible moment. She picked up a long rope that was lying nearby near her chair. She tried to hang herself. She wanted to end her unhappy life. Minerva held her back. "No, I won't let you die, you wicked girl. But from this moment, you shall always hang from a thread. You shall spin and weave all your life. And because you are so proud, I shall punish you forever and ever." In a moment, all Arachne's pretty hair fell off her head. Her face became very small with great shining black eyes. Her body became small and black. Her beautiful busy fingers changed into a long hairy legs. She was a spider hanging on a thin thread from a corner of ceiling. The pupil watched as the busy little animal began to weave a web across the corner of the room. The thread was very thin and strong. The web was very beautiful. The first spider was getting ready to catch flies for her supper. Ever since then, spiders have spun their silk thread and woven their beautiful webs. And the name Arachne makes us think about the foolish girl and the jealous goddess. So the reading was done. Let's talk about Arachne. As we all have understood from the reading that Arachne was a foolish girl and she challenged goddess Minerva because she thought that her work is better than goddess Minerva. And goddess Minerva, we have learned in the last lecture that she is a cruel and fierce goddess, and she did some artwork, and she was the goddess of art and knowledge because Minerva gave a chance to Arachne, and she try to make her understand that she should beg pardon and she should apologize from her and never boasted about her. But Arachne was used to boasting about herself, about her skills, and when she met to the Minerva, so she challenged her, and in front of all the people, all the visitors, so the test began. And no doubt Arachne's work was better than Minerva's work, so Arachne was the winner of the test because she drew a very beautiful picture. The subject of Minerva's picture was about foolish human being because she wanted to explain that Arachne is doing some foolish act in front of her, and Arachne's picture's subject was about that even the gods can make mistakes sometimes. So that was also a very wrong act in front of goddess. So that's why Minerva became very angry, and when she became angry and after watching his aggressive face, her aggressive face, so Arachne came to know that she did mistake and she is in terrible moment, in a very huge danger. She begged pardon from goddess Minerva, but it was too late. After doing lots of misbehaving, she wanted to beg a pardon, beg apologize, so that was not okay. For that, Minerva punished her and hit her on the head by stick. And then Arachne also committed suicide. She tried to hang herself, but Minerva punished her. She did not kill her. She changed Arachne into a spider by doing magic. Because we have understood that Minerva is a fierce goddess, and goddess can do magic and all that. So, because in this time, that was very embarrassing moment for Minerva. So that's why Minerva punished Arachne, and she changed Arachne into a spider. And now from that time, spiders win and weave the threads and catch flies for herself. So in the picture you can see what is the moral of the story. The moral of the story is don't be very proudy, don't be very arrogant, be humble and be kind with everyone. So that was the story. Hope you have understood and enjoyed it. Thank you.